Hello friends, good morning. We were studying the non-specific defense mechanism. Non-specific defense mechanism. Under this, we were under the non-specific defense mechanism, there are mainly first line and second line of defense. Yes, which is first line of defense mechanism of the vertebrate body and second line of defense mechanism. In this particular lecture, let us discuss what is first line of defense mechanism. Under the first line of defense mechanism, body structure, vertebrate body architecture, or body structure plays important role. Different organs, system, and their functioning gives the or that constitute the first line of defense mechanism. Under the first line of defense mechanism, mainly the elements like skin is there, mucus secreted by mucociliary epithelial cells, then our digestive system, architecture and working of digestive system. Then fourth is respiratory system. Fifth is genitourinary system. Then sixth element is our eyes and ears. So architecture and functioning of these different systems of the body constitute the first line of defense mechanism. Now let us discuss first defense barrier, that is the skin. How skin play important role in giving defense? How skin involved in the non-specific defense mechanism? Now, under the non-specific defense mechanism, a common resistance or a common defense was given. A general defense mechanism is operated against all type of the foreign material entering into the cell. So, let us say first element of the first line of defense, skin. How skin act as a defense barrier? How skin inhibit entry of any foreign metal into the body? First and very important thing is, as skin is intact, that intact nature of the skin avoid entry of any foreign material into the body. All of you know that skin is always exposed to the external environment, and from that external environment, large number of pathogens, not only pathogens, large number of different types of foreign substances are in direct contact with the skin. But because skin is intact, organism cannot easily enter into the body. Next and very important is, here skin consists of a external surface consists of stratum corneum type of the horny cells, which consist of a complex protein. The name of that complex protein is called as keratin protein. And this keratin protein is very complex. And on this keratin protein, organisms cannot able to grow. So organisms cannot degrade that keratin. And that's why organisms cannot be allowed to grow on the skin. Here on the skin, there is presence of sebaceous gland. Sebaceous gland, all of you know that this gland, the function of gland is to secrete the sebum. Sebum is nothing but sweat. When there is heavy exercise or when person suffers from a fever, then body secrete large amount of the sweat, or there is sweating or perspiration. It is also called as perspiration, ghameni. So secretion of the sebum or sweat is one of the best defense barrier given by the body, because when the sebum was secreted or sweat was secreted, this sweat was chemically very complex. First is, it is hypertonic. It consists of large amount of salt, NaCl. Because of the hypertonic nature, organisms cannot be easily grown in presence of the sebum. At the same time, this sebum consists of complex lipids, and that complex lipid, for example, oleic acids are there. This can be non-degradable by the organism. So organisms cannot easily grow in presence of sebum. Otherwise, besides that, organisms get killed in presence of the sweat. So in presence of the sebum. So secretion of the sebum itself is antimicrobial, or itself is killing the microorganisms. So that is another mechanism. The next mechanism is here skin consists of a external layer called as squamous epithelial cell. Squamous epithelial cell. These epithelial cells are frequently removed from the skin by the process of desquamation. By the process of desquamation, these cells are frequently removed, and along with that, organisms loaded are also removed by the process of desquamation. Desquamation म्हणजे कोंडा जो येतो तो कोंडा येतो ही डेड स्किन आपली निघून जाते बाहेरची. And along with that dead skin, organisms settled on that cells get removed during the process of desquamation. Then next is skin also operate another mechanism, and that is healthy skin always has a normal flora. Normal flora are the organisms residing on the skin. Usually their habitat is our skin. They are normally present on the healthy skin, or they are always present on the healthy skin. These organisms are called as normal flora, and the best example is Staphylococcus aureus, or you may see it as a Staphylococcus, genus Staphylococcus, organisms from the genus Streptococcus and Propionibacter. So these organisms act as a normal flora. Here these organisms reside on the healthy skin and break down the complex lipids present on the skin and convert it into the acid and produce acid and maintain acidic pH on the skin. And the in such acidic condition produced by this normal flora, other organisms cannot able to grow. So that is one of the best mechanism operated role of normal flora. Normal flora protect the skin by creating acidic condition on the skin, and other organisms cannot able to grow on such acidic condition. So this another mechanism is also there, that is dryness of the skin. Skin is totally dry, and on such a dry skin, normally organisms cannot able to grow. So intact nature of the skin and dryness of the skin are very helpful to protect the skin or to protect the body against the invasion of different types of the organism. So that is how skin play important role in the first important role in the defense mechanism, or it is the first element of the first line of defense mechanism. Now let us discuss second, that is the mucus. How mucus act as a defense mechanism, or how mucus gives the defense mechanism. Here mucus was secreted by all mucociliary cells. It is secreted by all mucociliary cells, cell linings, mucociliary cell linings present on the inner surface of each system wall means aple je sagla system hai, respiratory system, digestive system, then your nose and eyes, tacha atla bajne inner, from inner side, suppose this is any system, from inner sides there is presence of this mucociliary lining which secrete the mucus. Te kay secrete kartat? Mucus is a slimy mucilaginous slippery substance, and that mucus blanket is present on the inside of the system wall. So it is a mucociliary blanket present at the inner surface of the system wall. Now how this mucus play important role in giving defense barrier? Now what happens when we studied the composition of mucus? First is composition of the mucus. Mucus consists of antimicrobial substances. The substances like IBP protein, iron binding protein, and one of the best example is transferrin. So transferrin is present. It is iron binding protein. We will see the role of IBP in the when we discuss the second line of defense. Here we will discuss this transferrin. Only here remember that mucus consists of IBP protein, transferrin, as well as it consists of antibodies IgA. Because of such antimicrobial substances, if organism enters into the system, suppose this is the organism, if it enters into the system and when it come in contact with the mucus, because of such composition of the mucus, antimicrobial substances in the mucus, this organism was killed. So composition of the mucus play important role in killing of organism. Second, very important is this inner walls of the system has a cilia. It is cilia astar. This cilia has a ciliated motion. Because of that ciliated motion, they flushed out mucus or they flush mucus in a forward direction. So along with the mucus, the organism settled on the mucus, get flushed out with the help of ciliated cilia. So ciliated motion flushed out the mucus, and along with the mucus, organisms also get removed from the system. So constant flushing of the mucus from the system removes the organism or inhibit organism from binding with the system wall. हा organism ला इथं अटॅच व्हायला येत नाही. ऑर्गॅनिझम जर सिस्टीम वॉलला अटॅच झाला, ग्रो झाला, तरच तो इन्व्हेड करेल, तरच तो डिसीज कॉज करेल. त्याला इथं अटॅच व्हायला हा ब्लँकेट, म्युकोसलरी ब्लँकेट, दॅट इज अ थर्ड मेकॅनिझम. म्युकोसलरी ब्लँकेट जे आहे सिस्टीमच्या आतल्या बाजूनी, दॅट म्युकोसलरी ब्लँकेट म्हणजे काय तर सिस्टीम आतल्या बाजूनी म्युकसनी कोट केलेली असते आणि म्युकसवर ऑर्गॅनिझम अटॅच होतात, पण सिस्टीम पर्यंत जाऊ शकत नाही, त्या सेल्स ऑर्गन पर्यंत जाऊ शकत नाही. सो म्युकोसलरी ब्लँकेट इनिबिट ऑर्गॅनिझम्स टू गेट अटॅच ऑन द वॉल्स ऑफ द सिस्टीम. सो दीज आर द थ्री मेकॅनिझम्स. नाऊ लेट अस डिस्कस थर्ड एलिमेंट, दॅट इज द डायजेस्टिव्ह सिस्टीम. येस, नाऊ हाऊ डायजेस्टिव्ह सिस्टीम gives the defense barrier, which are the mechanisms operated in the digestive system. Normally what happen here, digestive tract infections occur when organism grows in large intestine, when organism succeeded to reach in the large intestine, and if this organism grow in the large intestine, then only there is gastrointestinal tract infection. Tract infection, or you may call it as a intestinal infection. So in this digestive system, a mechanism is operated such that organism cannot reach up to the large intestine. Now what type of mechanism is there in the digestive system? Here digestive system, mainly the parts of digestive system, that is mouth, then next is stomach, then third one is your small intestine, next is large intestine. Here they have some mechanisms to avoid the or to kill the foreign antigen entering into the intestine. Now first of all, let us discuss the mouth. Here there is constant bathing of mouth due to with the saliva. आपण लाळ सिक्रेट होतो म्हणतो ना, ती लाळ म्हणजे saliva. So there is salivation. The process of salivation, usually this process of salivation was increased in case of mouth infection. आपण दात काढला, तोंड आलेलं असेल, माउथ इन्फेक्शन असेल काही, तर सलायवेशन वाढतं, त्याला म्हणतात ओव्हर सलायवेशन. सो दिस ओव्हर सलायवेशन ऑर सलायवेशन इज अ मेकॅनिझम, डिफेन्स मेकॅनिझम बाय द बॉडी. नाऊ हाऊ दिस सलायवेशन प्रोटेक्ट द बॉडी फ्रॉम एंटरिंग ऑर्गॅनिझम्स फ्रॉम माउथ टू द माउथ. Now what happens, due to the constant bathing of mouth, constant secretion of saliva, organisms, first and very important is that saliva was always consist of, or the composition of saliva consist of, again IBP protein, that is lactoferrin. It consists of IBP protein, lactoferrin, and again IgA antibodies are present in the saliva, and that these are antimicrobial property, or they are antibacterial property. Here what happens, this if organism enters, because mouth is a body is such opening that along with any food material or that we are eating, all that material carries thousands of organisms. So there is direct entry of organism along with the food material that we are taking. So to avoid the entry of organism, through the mouth. First and most important mechanism is salivation. When this we observe the composition of saliva, saliva is rich in IBP protein, lactoferrin. At the same time, antibodies IgA, both are antimicrobial. So organisms in contact with the saliva directly get killed. Then next is, there is constant flushing of saliva from the mouth. Because of that, apun saliva ji secret hote thi, swallow karun daktu. That is, during that, saliva get flushed out from the mouth. Because of that, organisms settled on the gum or teeth are get removed from from their position. So there is removal of organism during the flushing of saliva. Our organisms are inhibited to settle on the teeth. Teeth gum किंवा टीथच्या हिरड्यांवर ऑर्गेम सेटल होऊ शकत नाहीत. बिकॉज ऑफ सलायवा ऑर्गेजम्स गेट स्वॅलो और फ्लश्ड आउट फ्रॉम द माउथ. सो दॅट इज अनदर मेकॅनिझम. दो थर्ड मेकॅनिझम इज ड्युरिंग द चिविंग प्रोसेस. ड्युरिंग द चिविंग प्रोसेस देर इज मेकॅनिकल इंजुरी. आपण जे अन्न खातो, चावून खातो, त्यावेळेला ऑर्गेनिझमला मेकॅनिकल इंजुरी होते. And due to that mechanical injury, some of the organisms may get removed. During the chewing, saliva was mixed in the food material and the organisms are killed with the saliva because of such antimicrobial property of the saliva. So that is the mechanism of the operated in the mouth. Though lot of organism enters along the food material and after the mouth, they enters into the stomach. Now what is the mechanism operated in the stomach? All of you know that stomach is rich in gastric juice. Yes, and that gastric juice is HCl. It is normally one normal HCl. The pH of stomach is about 2 to 3. It is highly acidic, and because of such acidic condition, organism entering from mouth along with the food material, they are directly killed in the stomach because of high acidity. So high acidity is the mechanism in the stomach to kill the organism. But what happens, some of the organism may survive in that acidic condition and they may remain withstand. And then after the stomach, they enters into the small intestine. Kahi organism je stomach madhe survive hotat te pude kute tat small intestine madhe. Now small intestine consists of secretion called as pancreatic juice. So pancreatic juice is there. The pH of small intestine is usually 6 to 7. It is alkaline pH. And what happens? The organism survived in the stomach, which get withstand at high acidity, enters into the small, when they enters into the small intestine, immediately there is pH shift from 2 to 3 pH to 6 to 7 pH. And that drastic change in the pH is the pH shock to organism. So the organisms which remain in stomach, which survive in stomach, when they enters into the small intestine, immediately when they enters into the small intestine, they get killed due to the pH shock. So that is the nice mechanism operated in stomach and small intestine. Though some organisms remain in small intestine, will get entry into the large intestine. They succeeded to enter into the large intestine. Now, if they grow in the large intestine, you are going to be infected. We are going to be cause or suffers from that particular gastrointestinal infection. So what mechanism is operated in the large intestine? In the large intestine, all of you know that large intestine is rich in normal flora. A second site of the body is the large intestine. First site is our skin. Skin carries normal flora. Second location is the large intestine, where we generally observe the normal flora organisms, and the organisms like E. coli. Another is the lactobacillus. Third one is the lactobacillus. Third one is your again propionibacter. These such organisms are always present in our large intestine, and they act as a normal flora of the intestine. Here, how they protect the intestine, what is the role of this normal flora in the defense mechanism? What happens, this normal flora which are normally present in our large intestine, convert sugars from food material we are taking into the acids. आपण जे food material खातो त्यातले sugar चं conversion ते acid मध्ये करतात. And in due to the production of acid, other organisms can get killed. So this other organisms get killed in presence of such acid produced by the normal flora. So that is how organisms kill. This normal flora do not allow growth of organisms into the intestine. At the same time, another mechanism is operated in the intestine, that is peristalsis. Peristalsis means, suppose this is the intestine. Here, inner wall of the intestine, ciliated wall of the intestine, or this wall has a rhythmic motion of the intestinal wall is there. This is called as peristalsis. The element of peristalsis, it is progressive, constant, rhythmic. म्हणजे एका ठराविक लयबद्ध पद्धतीने ही इंटेस्टिनल वॉल आत हलत असते तुमची. त्याला पेरिस्टालसिस म्हणतात. And during this, due to this peristalsis, there is forward flow of the content, forward flow of the food material from the large intestine. हे फॉरवर्ड फ्लो होतं ना, ऑर्गेनिझम्स आर ऑल्सो फ्लो फ्लश आउट फ्रॉम द इंटेस्टाईन अलॉंग विथ द म्युकस अँड अदर फूड मटेरियल. सो अलॉंग विथ द म्युकस अँड अदर फूड मटेरियल दीज मायक्रो ऑर्गेनिझम्स आर रिमूव्ह फ्रॉम द इंटेस्टाईन ऑर दे आर पुश्ड फॉरवर्ड विथ द हेल्प ऑफ दिस पेरिस्टालसिस मुवमेंट. पेरिस्टालसिस इज द कॉन्स्टंट रिदमिक फॉरवर्ड मुवमेंट ऑफ द intestinal wall that helps to remove organism along with the mucus and food material. So that is the good mechanism operated in the large intestine. So these are the different mechanisms operated in the digestive system, which are these: mouth, stomach, small intestine, large intestine. In the mouth there is secretion of the saliva. It one of the good mechanism which consists of IBP protein, lactoferrin and IgA antibodies. This is antimicrobial. The next is constant flushing of the saliva from the mouth removes organism as well as avoid organism to get adhere on the gums. Then next is there is chewing mechanism. During the chewing, there is mechanical injury to the food. Now while talking about the stomach, gastric juice of the stomach has 1-2 pH, and in such acidic condition, majority of the organisms get killed. Those organisms which get survive enters into the small intestine, and in the small intestine, the pH of small intestine is 6-7 because of the pancreatic juice. And when some organisms which survive in the stomach, when they enters into the small intestines, there is immediate pH shift or pH shock. Because of that shock, majority of the organisms will get killed. Then some of the organisms remain enters into the large intestine. In the large intestine, normal flora play important role by producing acids from the sugars of the food material, and in such acidic condition, other organisms cannot able to grow. And next and very important mechanism is peristaltic movement of the intestinal wall for push forward the microorganisms along with the mucus and food material. So that is the mechanism operated at the digestive system. Fourth element is the respiratory system. Again, while talking about the respiratory system, it is very important to know that this respiratory infections occur only when organism succeeded to enter up to the lungs. And if they grow in the lung, then only there is respiratory infection. So body operates such a mechanism that organisms cannot easily allow to enter up to the lungs. Now what mechanism is there in the respiratory system? Here respiratory system mainly divided in three regions, nose or nasal chambers. Then upper respiratory system is there, or respiratory canal is there, upper respiratory system, or you may say it as a respiratory canal, and third one is your lungs. Now what happens in the nose nasal chambers? There is presence of two different mechanisms, or two mechanisms are operated at the nose. First is inner lining of the nose. Inner lining of the nose was ciliate consists of cilia or nasal hairs are there. Yes, nasal hairs are there. At the same time, there is secretion of the mucus from the inner surface of the nasal orifices or nasal chamber. Because of this hairs, the material or air along with the air, the extraneous material during the inhalation, due to that air pressure and air current, some of the foreign material enters into the nose. That foreign material get filtered out in the nasal chambers due to the nasal hairs. Nasal hairs get filtered out, filter that foreign material entering through the air. At the same time, due to the slimy mucus, chikadje mucus, because of that, they get arrested in the mucus. They get settled on the sticky mucus. So filtering and attachment or arresting the foreign material, because of these two mechanisms, large number of extraneous matter coming along with the air get filtered at the nasal chamber. But what happen? Those particles which are very small, you may say it as a droplet nuclei, they smaller sized nuclei or smaller sized particle, due to the air pressure of inhalation, they directly enters and are succeeded to pass through the lungs, and even they enters into the respiratory system. Here again, there is presence of cilia as well as mucus. That ciliated motion, that mucus loaded with the foreign material get flushed out from the respiratory system, or they get removed from the respiratory system. Now the organisms which enters into the respiratory canal, they are trapped by mucus present on the inner wall of the respiratory system, and along with the ciliated motion, they get flushed out, or they are not allowed to settle on the respiratory canal. Now the particles which are succeeded, the particles which are very small, they can successfully enters up to the lungs due to the air pressure. Apan je shwas ghetto tya shwasacha pressure ne barik particles easily enters through the respiratory canal, and they succeeded to enter up to your lungs. Now what mechanism is there in the lungs? Here at the opening of the lung, there is presence of the pulmonary alveoli cells, or they are also called as alveolar phagocytic cells, or you may say it as a guard cells. So that means guard cells. These guard cells are present at the opening of the lung. These alveolar phagocytic cells, guard cells, or pulmonary alveoli are ready to capture the particles coming through the respiratory canal, and these small particles entering through the respiratory canal can easily get captured and phagocytized by this alveolar phagocytic cell, and that is how they are banned to enter into the lungs. Suppose some organism succeeded to enter into the lungs, the lungs for the gelage organism, so the by the involuntary actions of the body like coughing, sneezing, khokto apan shingto, these are the involuntary actions given by the body to expel out organisms from the lung. So these activities, coughing and sneezing, are the defense mechanism operated to protect the lungs. So these are the mechanisms operated at the respiratory system: nose, upper respiratory canal, and lungs. In the nose, nasal hairs are there, mucus is there, which filter out and block the organisms to enter. Pulmonary alveolar or alveolar phagocytic cells or guard cells are there at the opening of lungs, which protect the lung by engulfing any foreign material entering into the lung. And lastly, coughing and sneezing are the involuntary actions given by the body to protect the lungs. So that is about the lungs. Now next system is the genitourinary system. Now again, while talking about the urinary system, if organism succeeded to grow or enter up to the kidney, then only you observe the major urinary tract infections. Here, in case of kidney, while talking about the urinary system, the most important part is the kidney. Now, what happens here? This kidney secrete the urine, and when it secrete, urine is sterile. Yes, when urine is present in the kidney, it is sterile. But urine was secreted, and when it travels down to the bladder, to ureters, and from urethral opening, it was discarded. Urethral opening, it was excreted from the body. Now what happens in the kidney? Urine was sterile, but when it come in contact with the urethral opening and ureters, it start to get contaminated. Here there are the mechanism operated at to protect the urinary tract to protect the body against urinary tract infection is this bladder and ureters. Here urethra consists of a normal flora. This normal flora usually do not allow other organisms to grow in the ureters. At the same time, the length of urethra and forward flow of urine, urethra chi ji length hai, the length ani forward flow of urine avoid organisms to reach up to the lungs, to reach up to the kidney. So forward flow of urine from the ureters, that is first mechanism which do not allow orgasm. Itha tumhala infection che chances kutne from this urethral opening. Urethral opening pasun ureters, bladder and kidney. Asha jar organism travel zale tar urinary tract infection occur hota generally. Mechanism mahatvacha kutla tar forward flow of urine from kidney, bladder, ureters avoid orgasms to enter. That is the first and very important mechanism, forward flow of urine. And second and very important is composition of the urine. Urine itself is highly antibacterial because it has a low pH. It is hypertonic, so organisms cannot able to grow. It consists of complex acids like uric acid, tipuric acid, complex fatty acids are there. And because of that, organisms cannot survive in the urine, and urine do not allow organisms to grow. And another mechanism is forward flow of urine do not allow organisms to enter up to the lungs. So that is about the urinary system. While talking of the genital system here, this vagina consists of a normal flora. Organism, and that organism is lactobacillus. Lactobacillus acidophilus is present as a normal flora of the vagina, and this organism has property to produce, to ferment glycogen secreted in the vaginal epithelial cell. This glycogen secreted in the semen. Glycogen secreted by vaginal epithelial cells. So semen consists of glycogen. That glycogen was converted into the lactic acid by this lactobacillus acidophilus. And this lactic acid cannot allow other organisms to grow. So this lactobacillus acidophilus, a normal flora of vagina, protect vagina by producing acid. Other organisms cannot able to grow. At the same time, this semen secreted in the vagina consists of some antimicrobial substances like zinc. Zinc is there, as well as spermin is there. Spermin is there, which are antimicrobial, which again kills the organism. So this is the mechanism operated in the genital system, and by this is how genitourinary system get protected. Now last point remaining is eyes and ears. Now what is the mechanism operated in eyes and Now, in case of eyes and ears, the mechanism operated is eye is eyeball, external eyeball is in constant contact with the high air or environment, and that should be protected from foreign particles. So there is constant flushing of the tears on the external eyeball, and that constant flushing protect the eye, because that tears, when we observe the composition of tear consists of again IBP protein, lactoferrin, transferrin and IgA protein, the IgA antibodies. These IgA antibodies and transferrin are antimicrobial substances. Those organisms which get settled on the tear can easily get killed. So there is constant thin layer of tears always present on the external eyeball, and that protect the eyeball. In case of the tears, there is also presence of enzyme lysozyme. And in case of external ear is in direct contact to the environment. The secretion of waxy mucus on the inner portion of external eye protect that ear. External waxy secretion of the mucus secreted at inner portion of the external ear prevent the entry of organism into the ear, and that is how eyes and ears are also protected. So these are the defense mechanisms operated by as a first line of defense mechanism. And now in next lecture, we'll see the second line of defense, which are the different mechanisms operated by body to avoid the infection, to avoid the entry of pathogens. So here we'll stop. Thank you.